Can I just start this off by saying I love Mike Tyson? Please, Mike Tyson, do not come and kill me. Please. You like that intro? Would you believe that I paid someone like $1,000 to do that intro? Would you believe that? I didn't just do it myself, like in 30 seconds or a minute. What's going on, everybody? Jamin here for Review Week, where I do reviews and stuff. And today I have a movie, The Fabled Desert Strike. And I was doing a little bit of research before this. I mean, you guys know the story. You watch the vlog if you haven't watched the vlog about my Desert Strike story. But I was doing a little bit of research, and it shows here Devil's Strike, also known as Pharaoh's War. That has the same exact cover, but the poster. But it's Pharaoh's War. Why didn't they just call it in America? Because this is a Middle Eastern movie. Why didn't they just call it Pharaoh's War here too? Why did they have to change it to Desert Strike? Because that doesn't—it's not really relevant to what this movie actually is. There's not really a desert strike. It's more of like a rescue mission type movie. And the original title doesn't make sense either, honestly. But it's a little bit better than Desert Strike. As cooler, in my opinion. So we're gonna talk about Pharaoh's War, aka Desert Strike, directed by Raouf Abid El Aziz. And you can't find anything about this guy. I couldn't even find a picture of him. On IMDb, it just shows up blank picture. So he is a great up-and-coming filmmaker, obviously. It shows that he's done one movie before this and then some TV show directing. And he does cinematography. And things like that. He has another movie in pre-production already. So, based off the success of this, so let's just get into the story of Desert Strike here for a bit. Okay, so Mike Tyson plays Rick. The Mountain plays Frank, and they have a scene in the very beginning of the movie. It's the only scene that you should watch. Just Google it, Facebook it, YouTube it. Watch the first scene. It's pretty funny. And it's pretty bad. So what I try to do with these movies is find something. There's gonna be a Walmart gem somewhere. I'm gonna find one of these that is just really so bad it's good. And spoilers alert for this. It's not so bad it's good. It's just it has some spikes. It has some moments, but it's not all consistent all the way through. Sadly. So anyway, Mike Tyson is a savior of people that are being affected by bad people in the area. They're refugees from the war, I guess. But Frank has a camp that he just kidnaps people and he brings them there and he forces the children to become his soldiers or whatever. He brainwashes them basically. You kind of see one scene of that. So they meet up in the first of the movie and he cap get Rick gets captured, aka Mike Tyson gets captured, who's looking fit, by the way, let me tell you. Mike, please, no, don't hurt me. But for real though, Mike Tyson is the best part of this movie. He's just so wonderful on screen. Everything he does is just so bad. His acting is bad. His like punching and stuff is bad. His choreography, because he's swinging hard, but he's pulling his punches so close to like his body, because he doesn't want to actually punch somebody in this movie because he would end their fucking life. And it's so cute and adorable to see his fighting and his punching. He's the best part of this movie, and he's literally only in about 15 minutes of this 1 hour and 55 minute long movie. He's in like 15 minutes of it. So yeah, we have it's one of them type of movies. You get bamboozled. We have the Mountain guy and Mike Tyson, who are top billed, and they're both in it for, a little a quarter of the movie. Frank is the Mountain guy is actually only in about like 20 minutes of the movie, 25 minutes of the movie. He's in a little bit more than Mike Tyson, but not a whole lot. The Mountain guy, you see his name. Why did his agent? Does he have an agent? Change your goddamn name. Tom Cruise, Action Jackson. Change your name to something like Mike Tyson. It's his real name, but it sounds better than at least you can pronounce it. If you're wanting to be an American actor, you have to have something that you can say in American, in English, my guy. Something different than this, whatever that is. Anyways, looking at the cover or the poster, keeps saying cover poster, one man will survive. So it looks like it's going to be a movie combating these two forces together against each other. No, it's not. It is a rescue mission movie. The one of the girl's sons gets captured, and our main girl kind of son gets captured, and it's the main protagonist's son. So he goes on a rescue mission, and he gathers around his Fast and Furious team of one guy is a really good shot with a bow and arrow, or damn it, I can't even think of what that thing is called, but, you know, it's a bow and arrow, but a gun.
Crossbow.
But that translates into he's a good shot with everything. Then you got your parkour guy, you got another lady who can climb stuff. She can climb anything, kind of like Slipknot from that one movie. And you got an explosives guy. Anyway, there's lots of characters in this movie, and they all take up way too much time, and there's way too many scenes, and it's just kind of a big mess. He lies to all of his friends, and he says, hey, there's $10 million in this camp that Frank owns. Let's go steal it. And they're like, all right, $10 million. But we see, and that's a lie, but we see Frank putting up gold bars in a safe in this place. So I'm like, well, wait a minute. Did the protagonist know about the money? And he's just lying to them for no reason, or he's not lying to them, actually. But I thought he was lying to them. And it turns out he was lying to them. He didn't know anything about the gold. And guess what? The gold is not even ever found. No one, they don't use it. I thought they were going to find the gold and like, oh, celebrate at the end of the movie. Yeah, you guys, you get all the money. Remember that I promised you money and that I lied and there's not money? Well, guess what? Psych, there is money. But that doesn't happen. And all those people, his friends, almost all of them fucking die. Spoilers alert. And then that's the end of the movie. Like, oh, he gets his son back. Frank dies in a car accident. He runs him off the road, and it's hilarious because he's in the. They keep putting the mountain guy in tiny cars. There's like two cars in this movie that he gets into, and they're both super tiny little cars. And he just gets in there, and it's like, why? You want to make him look big and towering, but they don't really do that too well in this movie. In Game of Thrones, he looks like a big hulking dude, and you can really grasp the size of this man. He looks big, but not like a towering human being. The action in this movie, there's a lot of action. The last 35 minutes of this movie is just one super long action scene, and it's kind of boring at some points, but there's a lot of stuff that happens. A lot of his friends die, like I said. They get shot in funny ways, or not funny ways, but they just get kind of shot and die. It just goes on for way too long. There's a lot of scenes and stuff I could talk about, but it's really, you know, it's not that funny. You know, there's not that much funny stuff. The funniest part of this movie is that I think, Middle Eastern people, Muslims, what language do they speak? Arabic? Do they speak Arabic? Is that right? Hold on. Okay, yes. So hopefully I didn't come off like a real idiot, but yeah. Muslims speak Arabic, so I'm thinking this movie, it's horribly dubbed over by English actors. I think it's supposed to be in Arabic, and they horribly dubbed it, like I said, but the subtitles, I don't really have subtitles for the option on Amazon. It just came up closed captions, and the closed captions say nothing. They don't say anything close to what the English dub is. So I think, and it just seems kind of like the script, or like if they just wrote out, like when they did the closed captions, someone typed out what the lines were in the script, and then they just didn't bother to change them for the dub version. So a lot of it is, what they say is nothing what you're reading. And you know why I turned on the subtitles? Oh, you would think because the dub is bad, or you would think you turn on the subtitles whenever there's, you know, it's a different language. No, I couldn't understand Frank the Mountain, the English-speaking man, who talks like this at the side of his mouth in a Scottish accent or something like that. It's like, and I had to turn on the subtitles so I could understand what the fuck he was saying. Little did I realize he would only be in the first scene of the movie, and then he was gone for 45 minutes to an hour, so I'd only turned on the subtitles for that one part, basically, because he doesn't have that much more speaking lines after that first scene. He just kind of mumbles and talks a couple lines, but his big monologue is in the start of the movie. And then there was twice that there was just no dialogue. This lady talks twice. This lady talks twice in the movie. Her mouth is moving, literally. And nothing, no dub comes out. No words come out. And I'm like, what is she supposed, is she saying something there? What is she saying? Am I missing it? Is it something important? Hopefully not. I don't know if it had to be cut out because of a censor or something, but this movie's not rated. It's pretty violent. There's like some stabbings, like in the start of the movie, the girl stabs her dad. There's a lot of blood, like squibs that are kind of cool at some points, but other than that, it's not too violent. So I can imagine they don't swear that much in the movie either. I don't think I even remember any swears. No memorable action scenes, no memorable fights. Like Mike Tyson fights this one big dude with another dude that helps him kind of, and he does this funny thing where he's like punching in front of the camera, and the dude's like, that was not that cool. There's a lot of this. Like someone has a gun, and there's like a lot of, and then it completely cuts to a different guy, and he's just like, getting shot, and they do that a lot. Like there's a guy like, and then it cuts to them, and they're like, it's not like in John Wick, when he goes through like corridors or he goes to places and he's like shooting people, bam, 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 and they're both in the scene together, they're both in the shot, and the guy reacts to it, or he shoots them at close range. There's like none of that in this movie. It's all from boom, 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 boom. And that's a lot of characters just walking around in fire at the very end. There's like the town is completely destroyed. Everything's on fire. And he's just walking around with two guns. Poof, 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 in this war zone. And it's ridiculous. So that's it. 4.5 out of 10. Because there is some fun. Funny elements to the movie that can keep you in there invested, but at the end of the day, it's mostly boring. And if you would have told me Mike Tyson and Frank were in the movie and they were the main characters, if you cut the Muslim Fast and Furious team out and it just had those two guys, then it would have been awesome, and I would recommend it to you. But as it is now, I would not recommend it. It's not worth the boring middle chunk of the movie. The start of it and the end of it, pretty good, entertaining enough. The middle chunk, not good. All right, so hopefully that was a concise, a clear vision of what I feel about this movie. And guess what? I'm the only person. I have the sole ownership of reviews on YouTube for Desert Strike. I looked at it and I've tried to find a review. I can't find one. I find trailer reactions, that's it. So I'm the only one to slog through this so far. Go me. All right, everybody, please like, subscribe, comment, all that YouTube bullshit if you enjoyed this. Stay tuned for another review, because I'm going to keep doing review week forever. Bye-bye.